this is Kelly Janae with Ethereal Ecology, and this is going to be a fun experiment kind of video. Today I am trying Sananga for the first time, which is an extract from a plant family, Apocynaceae, which I have been practicing my pronunciation all morning. And this is a tree and shrub family that grows, I think, all over, but this particular extract is from the Amazon rainforest, and they also call this family dogbane because they used to use it as dog poison, I guess, in certain places. And you may be wondering, Kelly, what do you do with this extract? Okay, well, so basically these are eye drops. They're called Sananga eye drops. This is 10 milliliters from Queen of the Forest, which is a supplier of certain plant medicines that I frequent. And yeah, it's a really simple little bottle, just some tape and, you know, Sananga, 10 milliliters. Okay. So these are eye drops. And I am going to take one eye drop into each eye and see what happens. So basically, this is considered medicine. It's medicinal. And aside from the actual plant properties, it's said to have spiritual properties that allow you to release stuck energies, negative thought patterns that are within your entire chakra system through your entire energy flow, but mostly through your third eye, your pineal gland, this upper chakra kind of area. And why am I taking this on a perfectly good Saturday when I could be doing anything else? Because yes, it is going to hurt, purportedly. Well, I definitely have been experiencing some sort of blockage in my third eye. I feel it like as if my, like an eye is like shut, you know? It's like I don't want to look at the true nature of reality, and I really want to see the true nature of reality because I want to be more open, and I just know that there's like potential that is waiting to be unlocked, and that especially is sort of blocking my ability to be open. And I can tell because not only because of that feeling, that like stuckness, but the fact that I have not been having as vivid of visions. There was a time when I was having very vivid visions and I was very open to what the universe had to say. And I would just randomly get like, you know, hold on, everyone. Like, you know, like I'm going into a trance. Okay, the eagle was here for you. And this guy is like, I got to send him to heaven or whatever. You know, it was like weird. And I think that maybe I've shut myself off from that a little bit, which is unfortunate because I really enjoy being close to source and getting information from the universe that I can then utilize to help me move through life or help other people navigate through life. So that's why I'm using this. It's medicinal, and the side effects of Sananga, it really just depends. I mean, I've never taken this before, so I don't know what to expect, but you can expect purging. I like vomiting, diarrhea, stuff like that. It really just depends on where you're at in your body, because whenever you're working with energy, you are working with the body as well. And you can have physical symptoms that it's good, you know, like on a spiritual level, a metaphysical level, to purge or to fast or to do anything like that, because it means that you're able to get rid of things that are no longer serving you so that you can move on. And you have to release it before you can let in anything else. So I've done a lot of, you know, work with my energy centers with different kinds of plant medicines, particularly hape, which I also get from Queen of the Forest. And so I feel pretty confident that I'm able to do this medicine today. And, you know, I may feel some nausea or whatever, fatigue. I'm not sure. But also aside from the spiritual things, it's supposed to have physical benefits for you as well. It's said to like cure people's eye problems and even things like blindness. First time I ever heard of this was from somebody who is not spiritual at all, who was talking about if you have eye issues, try Sananga. And I actually have had weird eye issues ever since college, and I think I can attribute that a little bit to just the fact that I was, like, you know, this far away from a computer screen and books all day long, studying and doing homework. But now that I'm able, like, I take breaks from the computer and all this stuff, there's still, like, some fuzziness to my vision. And I do believe that that is a byproduct of stuckness within my third eye center, and that any kind of illness associated with the eyes is similarly related. So, I would really like to see what happens as a result of this. This has just been in my fridge for maybe a month or more, just for me waiting for the right time, and it feels like the right time today. It was calling to me. So, what I'm going to do is, I'll speed through this part, but I'm going to open up sacred space, because to me, this is a ceremony. You know, there's something very special about this, and when you are releasing energy, you want to make sure that you are protected, that you've called in your spirit guides, that, you know, even if you're not, like, spiritual, it's good to at least get really grounded and have, I don't know, crystal allies. And I'm outside right now because I really feel like it's a better place to do ceremony than being stuck inside. So that's nice. And when I actually do the ceremony, I'm probably going to put headphones on and listen to some really calming music, just because I don't want to be distracted if a car rolls by or anything like that. I'm in a pretty private place, but I can still see or hear cars when they go through the neighborhood, which will distract me. So anyway, I'm going to open up sacred space. What I've just done is welcomed in the seven directions. I did it sort of in the Blackfoot tradition because that's what I've been trained in, but welcoming in the four directions of east, south, west, and north, and all of the animals and the plant medicines and the elements that are associated with each of those directions. And then I opened up with the fifth direction of Father Sky, Mother Earth, number six, and then the Great Mystery. Woo! And smudged myself a little bit. I'm probably going to light some more sage because can never have enough sage. Cleanses the stuck energy. It's supportive. Okie dokie. So, what's protocol here? Well, according to the Queen of the Forest website, it really only takes 1 to 2 drops of Sananga per eye to really have the effect. And so what you do is you lay down just so you can make sure that you get it into your eyeballs. And you try to drop in 1, 2. Like, you don't want to close your eyes until they both have Sananga, because you want it to be balanced as quickly as possible. And you want to make sure that you set your intention. So medicine is really only going to be as powerful as the intention that you have behind it. So it's always good before ceremony or anything to speak to the medicine, say, hey, this is what I want to get out of this, and your body will be more receptive to whatever's going to happen. I have a few crystals here that I'm going to be utilizing. I've got shungite rods that were a gift that I love. They're super grounded. I'm going to put these at my feet. I'm pretty grounded being on Mother Earth anyways, but seriously, never hurts. I have this giant thing of green calcite, which is a heart opening stone, and I've been really focusing on my heart today, so I'm gonna definitely have this here, because really it's like the gateway between Mother Earth and Father Sky. Your heart's got to be open. It just does. And then I have what's called seer stone. It's a type of smoky quartz, I guess you could say, but it's pretty beautiful. It's hard to see, but it's very clear, and they say they use it for, like, divination, and it really does help. Like, sometimes I'll just do this, and it'll help clear some things up. And then I also have citrine, which I may put this on my third eye. I may put this in my third eye, so I'm going to look weird, but, you know, I'm always looking weird. I've got my medicine staff here for support, in case I really feel like I need something to hold on to. I have water. Yay! I have a bandana just in case I want to, like, if I might cry and, like, whoa, you know, I don't know. Who knows? I welcome it. All right, so I'm going to do this thing, and we're going to see what happens. Am I nervous? I don't know. Not really. I'm pretty trusting in this medicine right now. So, let's do it. Nervous pee. I'm gonna report back. Okay, I'm back. As you could tell, that hurt really bad. Wow, I was not expecting it to hurt as bad as it did. When I opened it, it had like more of a sticky texture to it than I thought it would. It wasn't as like liquidy. It was more sticky and yeah, like half a second after I put it in the first one, I was like, oh my god, it stung so bad that I had to sit up and, like, oh, like, yell. It was that bad. It's been about 2 hours since I took it. I can still feel a little bit of, like, soreness in my eyes, but I would say after 3 minutes, it stopped hurting as bad, and it was on the down slope. But it definitely still hurt, like, 5 to 8 minutes in, and until I was really able to, like, lay down again, I was, like, afraid it was gonna be so painful that I wasn't able to lay down, and, I was really trying hard not to take off my headphones, because if you do this, really recommend having some calming music, something to ground you, or, like, being in complete silence in nature, but any sounds or, like, anything that can take you away from your breath and everything like that would just make this way more chaotic. So that was, like, the physical part of it. Spiritually, it was interesting. I spent a lot of time sort of narrating it for some reason. Like, I think we do that a lot with experiences, especially when we're gonna tell them to somebody afterwards. It's like, okay, so this is what's happening right now, and like I really was trying to narrate it for myself instead of, so I really had to, like, breathe into, okay, no, like, just forget about what's gonna happen afterwards and just be with the experience right now. And as I started to breathe into that, I could really sort of tell that there was some work going on up here. And there was a moment where I felt this pressure here, like as if my pineal gland and my third eye wanted to open up, but I had still, like, shut it off, and as if, like, what's out here is, like, this is, like, the screen, and the projector is the pineal gland, like, inside, and that's sort of how it felt, and it felt like the portal through which you're able to even, like, see what's going on in the projector, because everything is already in the projector. It's on the tape reel, you know, it's in there, but if you don't put up the screen in front of your freaking face, you know, you're not gonna get the reflection back. And so that's what I felt. It was like, okay, everything's going on inside of me, but I'm not allowing myself to see it outside of me. And there was a moment there where I was like, okay, what's keeping me from doing that? And I'm like, oh, it's just me. And so I was like, okay, I give myself permission to release whatever's here. And that really did, it had an effect. It had a lifting effect. And from that point on, I sort of really, really felt that analogy between this being a projector, my pineal gland I'm talking about, which is, like, in the middle of your brain, and then just, like, everything else is what it's showing you. And I think the biggest message that I got was that the pineal gland, in order to really, like, see the truth, we have to create space between the ego, the I, the Kelly Janae, and the actual witness itself. Because I think that we oftentimes get confused and think that we are the witness, I am the witness, I am witnessing everything, but we are perceiving what, you know, the patterns and the biases and just, like, the, we're perceiving what we think is real based on our preconceived notions that are a result of our lives being lived out as they are, and us being this somebody, this something, this, like, person with a personality and a role and all, just playing this game where, like, really we're just an empty vessel that's been molded through other external circumstances. But the message I was getting was to create space around my pineal gland in a way. It's like I could breathe in and, like, just, like, create spaciousness in that center. So I think that, you know, my body was telling me, like, you know, in the moment, I wasn't gonna see, like, the nature of the universe, you know, but, and I wasn't expecting to, but it was telling me, you know, like, if you want to keep, working on that, just do your best to breathe space around your pineal gland, to breathe space into your third eye, and not to think that you could possibly ever know what's going to happen here. You don't know, because this is like, hello, spirit, we don't know anything at all. Especially if we think we know, then we definitely, most definitely don't know. So that was like really interesting, and I'm glad that I did it. Would I recommend it? Personally, I feel like my vision is actually clearer, and you know, I didn't get any negative side effects, like nausea, vomiting. In the beginning, I thought I was going to be sick just because it hurt so bad. But then, you know, you just get over it. You're like, this sucks. Like, but it's temporary. And, you know, I feel good right now. And I also feel like the effects are going to continue to happen over the course of several days. And, you know, that very simple little insight of breathing space into the third eye and trying to find, you know, space between the eye, the me looking, and the whatever it is seeing. Because, yeah, and I also sort of, like, I was sort of, like, separating myself from my body in a way. I was like, okay, my pineal gland, like, what if it's really not a part of me? What if it's a part of, like, God? And really, that's what connects me to him, is that I have this I have a seat in the audience of the movie of life. And it's like this virtual reality is so real that, like, we forget that we can take off our glasses. But we just become whatever it is that we put these Kelly Janae glasses on, and we're like, okay, this is my life now, until I die, because I forgot that this is not reality. You know, there's just, like, there's some depth there, and it was very, very enlightening. And these aren't things that I've never thought of before, but it was just very pure awareness of that, the essence of God self, God wisdom within myself, or like, you know, words, semantics, myself, I don't know, within this vessel, there is a connection, a deep connection to the all that is, to God, to omniscience, to whatever. But the only thing that gets in the way of that is the ego, and we need the ego to move through life and to do the thing. But gosh, it's misleading and misguiding in so many ways. And yeah, so it's kind of nice to know that really, like, the key to wisdom is to just, like, forget about who you are, you know? Like, and that's been something I've been focusing on lately, too. It's like, what if I wanted to just be somebody else? What if I wanted to just do something completely unexpected and just not be, like, the person that I am right now and change, as long as it's, like, in line with my values? What would happen? I don't know. Who knows? And so it was just interesting questions, and I really, really, like, in retrospect, like, that sucked. But yeah, and when I'm talking about it, it was very cool. And so yes, I would recommend this to anybody who really is looking at trying to open up their third eye and all that stuff. If anything significant happens in the next couple days, I'll let you know. But for now, I'm going to, like, lay off that medicine for a little while, because it was really intense. But it does say that over time, if you use it more, it hurts less, which makes sense. That's sort of like the essence of healing. And I've had that happen with hape, which is this tobacco snuff sort of stuff that you can buy from Queen of the Forest, which you shoot up your nose into your nasal cavity, up, and that also works on some third eye stuff, and just it's a full body sort of cleansing. And when you first do it, it sucks. This was worse, in my opinion, than Hape ever was. But I think because it was in my eyeballs, like, it was just a new kind of pain that I was not really, you wouldn't necessarily impose that upon yourself. But yeah, like, the pain of Hape has gone down. You know, it's still like, oh, it's gonna hurt a little bit, and I'm just like, oh, in the beginning. But, you know, it subsides very quickly, and it's actually kind of pleasurable to have that little moment of, like, I'm alive, you know? Like, I'm living, this hurts, I love it, I love this! Oh, you know? It's just like, yeah. So, anyway, I hope you gained something from this. That was really interesting for me. I'm glad that I did it, and, yeah. Cool stuff. Love plant medicines. Peace.